First Peter chapter 5. Go ahead. I can't get this thing out like it needs to come out. So I'm going to be preaching. Amen. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen.
God will begin to show me some other things. Come with me to First Peter chapter 5. When you dare say amen.
Amen.
Let's start at 5 and then we have your seats and I'll keep reading. Likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elders. Yea, all of you be subject one to another, and be clothed with humility. For God resists the proud, and giveth grace to the humble. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time.
Amen.
Amen. You may have your seats in the presence of the Lord. Amen. It says, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Be sober. Everybody remember that sober means to watch.
Amen.
Amen. Be clear-headed. Have self-control. Come on, somebody. I mean, you know it's important that you have self-control when you're dealing with the devil. Amen. Another word for self-control is temperance. Temperance is on the board. That is the fruit of the Spirit, amen. That's one of the attributes of the Holy Ghost, amen. Is temperance, amen. And you need self-control to deal with the devil, amen. Praise God. And then it says, be vigilant to watch or be on guard. Keep watch, amen. That's something we found out, Sonny, that Adam wasn't doing. He was distracted, amen. Praise God. Then it says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil. How many of you know the devil is against you? He is your enemy. Amen. How many of you know that? He is your adversary. Your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion. We found out about the lion. That we found out about the attributes or the traits of a lion. Amen. Walking about seeking whom he may devour. The devil is, we found out also in Job, When the devil came, the sons of God came before God, and Satan came with him, the scripture says. And God asked him, he said, where have you been? He said, up and down the earth. Amen. Praise God. And you know what he's doing, walking up and down in the earth. He's seeking whom he may devour. Amen. Come on, somebody. He is your adversary. Are y'all with me? Amen. It says, whom resists steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who have called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. Y'all see that?
Amen.
Come with me to Ephesians. It says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
I'm going to just tell y'all like this. I'm so troubled in my spirit because God, this word God has given me. I said, Lord, why you keep telling me, giving me this message? What are you trying to get out of me? What are you trying to get to your people? And what God began to show me, he said, you don't pray, you become a what? A prayer. If you don't P-R-A-Y, you subject to be a P-R-E-Y. Amen.
Yeah.
And if you pray, amen, then you can resist the devil. Amen. Prayer, amen, P-R-A-Y-E-R, prepares you for the enemy. It alerts you. It gets you prepared. It's important to pray. But I was saying, Lord, God said, take the focus off prayer and put it on the enemy. Mm-hmm. And I said, why, Lord? He said, because if they knew the enemy they was dealing with, they would pray.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Right. Amen.
You got to know, amen, understand this enemy that we're dealing with. Amen.
Amen.
And he says in Ephesians, watch this. We know this. Chapter 6 of Ephesians. Verse 10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Y'all see this? Amen. It says, put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. In other words, without the armor, you can't stand.
Amen.
Against the wiles of the devil. That word wiles means schemes, strategy, and craftiness. In other words, amen, he's a strategist. I can't get this out enough. He is studying you.
Yeah,
that's good. He's watching you. Your tendencies. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
We found out Sunday he was watching Eve. The first place in the Bible where flesh was mentioned, Adam mentioned it. Amen. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
She's now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. Amen. And immediately Satan attacked the flesh. And it was the flesh that got him off track with God. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
And every time the flesh will get you out of the will of God, the works of the flesh. Let me just keep going. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the enemy. And then watch this now. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all to stand, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. And above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench the fiery darts of the wicked, and the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always. Praying what?
Always.
With all prayer and supplications in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplications for all saints. Amen. I'm going slow, but I want to let y'all see that we have to be, the Bible also says in 2 Corinthians, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, through the pulling down of strongholds, casting out imagination of every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. The Bible says our weapons are not carnal. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
The scriptures also said that you are a soldier of Jesus Christ in 2 Timothy. Amen. Chapter 12 says, endure hardship as a good soldier. A soldier fights. Come on, somebody. But a soldier has to be prepared to fight. Are y'all with me? A soldier has to be trained to fight. Are y'all with me? You are not in, praise God, you are in a fight today. Your biggest two enemies is the devil and your flesh. Come on, somebody. Y'all with me up in here. I say your biggest enemy is your flesh and the devil. And they work hand in hand. Come on, somebody. That's why the Bible said, walk in the Spirit and you won't fulfill the lust of the flesh. If you're in the Spirit, amen, you can deal with the devil. But if you're in your flesh, you leave yourself open for his attacks. And you cannot resist in your flesh.
That's good.
And it's a lot of times we think we're not in our flesh, but let me tell you, he's coming whether you in your flesh or not to see if you in your flesh. You have to remember, I can't get out unless I'm preaching. You have to remember that he's a strategist. He studies your habits. He studied Judas before he put it on Judas' heart to betray the Lord. He put it, come on, watch this. Jesus said, Satan desires to have you, Peter.
Yep.
Yep. Jesus said that. Why, Lord? To sift you like wheat. But I prayed for you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Come on. I'm telling you, I got a burden on me, man. Y'all just got to work with me, because look here, I got a burden for the church. Something is on me that God said the people are blind. They don't understand these attacks are coming from the enemy. And it's a thing, it's a movement going around. It's been going around for a long time. People are blaming God for evil.
Yeah.
And God said, you got to let the peace, let my, and the word that came to me, seeking whom he may devour, Satan, the word came to me by any means necessary.
Yeah.
He's coming to see about you, and by any means necessary, he wants to trip you up.
Yeah.
He's the God of this world.
Yeah.
The scripture says. The Bible says God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Amen. He loved the world. The scripture says that he created everything in the world. Are y'all with me? He created everything in the world. The book of Acts chapter 17 says that he created everything in the world. God so loved the world. But then the scripture says love not the world. Not the things that are in the world. Why? He loved the people. He loved creation. But the system is corrupt. What is the system? The lust of the flesh. The lust of the eyes. The pride of life. That is the system that is set up in the world. And the Bible says, be not conformed to the world. Be not a friend of the world. Why? The system. The lust of the eyes. The pride of life. And the lust of the flesh. Call me to Luke. Luke chapter 3. You know, can I just say what God has given me? God said many of my people think they're not being tempted. And you're calling God, you're saying something is God and it's not God, it's the enemy. Why? Because you're not sober.
Oh, good. That's
good. Yeah. That's
good. A drunk man is not alert. He don't know when the enemy's coming. He think he does. You can tell a drunk man, your enemy's coming. Okay. But he won't see him coming. Because he's not sober. And that's a man in the flesh. Oh, God. Watch this. Luke chapter. Luke chapter 4. I just want, this is not a Burger King. You have it your way. Walk. If you don't walk this walk the way it's supposed to be, thank God for grace. But don't you know we got an enemy? And he comes in like a flood. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Come on, somebody. And the world system, Jesus said, there was a woman bound for 18 years by the devil. She had an infirmity. The devil brings sickness on you, not God.
That's right.
Amen.
I'm trying to go somewhere. I'm trying to get this chaos. God said, I'm not the one that's causing my, I'm not allowing you to be sick.
Amen.
Right.
God said, stop saying, I allow evil to happen. Oh, I'm getting ahead of myself. And we accredit God for things that the devil's doing. Why? Because he's the God of the system. Sickness is in the system. Death is in the system. The kingdom of God, there's no sickness. There's no death. There's no lying, cheating, stealing. That's not in the kingdom of God. That's in the kingdom of darkness. That's in the world system that is set up by the devil.
Amen.
Amen.
Watch this. Four of Luke. Verse 3. And the devil said unto him, this is when Jesus was being tempted of the devil. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
The devil came and tempted God in the flesh. He was tempted in all points, the scripture says, yet without sin. If he came to tempt him, what makes you think he's not coming to tempt you?
Right.
And he was perfect. The perfect one, made flesh, the word of God, made flesh. And here comes the devil to tempt him. Are y'all with me?
Yeah.
The same devil that went to the third heaven. He went to the third heaven with the angels to bring an accusation against Job. The same devil that could stand in the presence of God want to destroy you. It's quiet up in here. Am I touching it? Is it touching home? Is it touching?
Yeah. Yeah.
You got to understand what we're dealing with. God said, how come my people not praying? They don't know what they're dealing with. That's why they're not praying.
Yeah.
Because if you knew what you were dealing with, man, you'd be on your knees 3-4 times a day. If you knew how he want to wipe you out. But oh, thank God for grace.
Yes.
Watch this. Jesus answered and said, he said, the devil said unto him, if thou be the Son of God, command this stone to be made bread. Jesus answered him, saying, it is written, that man should not live by what? Bread alone. But by every word of God. And the devil taketh him up a high mountain, watch this now, and showed him all the kingdoms of the world in the moment of a time. Y'all see this? And the devil said unto him, all this power. Y'all see that? All this, somebody say power.
Power.
All this power. He had all that power. Where he get it from? Adam. God didn't give it over to him. Adam surrendered it. Come on, watch this. He tells Jesus. Come with me to Acts right quick. Acts, we come back over there. Y'all just get the seat into this thing because I'm going off the Holy Ghost tonight, y'all. Y'all got to stay with me on this. Watch this. Here's Paul, Jesus appearing to Paul. When Paul went to Damascus. Y'all remember that story? And Jesus knocked him off his horse. He saw a bright light and fell off his horse. This is what Jesus said to Paul. Watch this. In Acts chapter 26, verse 14. And when we were all fallen to the earth, I heard a voice speaking unto me and saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? It is hard for thee to kick against the prick. And he said, who art thou, Lord? He said, I am Jesus whom thou persecutest. But rise and stand upon thy feet, for I have appeared unto thee for this purpose, to make thee a minister and a witness both of those things which thou hast seen and those things which I will appear unto thee, delivering thee from the people and from the Gentiles unto whom now I send thee, to open the eyes and to turn them from what? To what? From the what? Unto what? That they may receive forgiveness of sin and inheritance among them which is sanctified by faith that is in me. He said to turn them from darkness to light, from the power of sin. That tells me he got some power here. Your biggest enemy is him and your flesh. And they work hand in hand. If the Bible says God hates sin, don't God hate sin?
Yeah.
God hates sin, so what is the devil tempting you to do? Sin.
Yeah.
If he know God hates sin, then he's trying to get you to sin because God hates sin. And if I can get you to sin, then you out of the favor of God. His whole purpose. evil. Even if she's doing good, well, let me see, can she handle sickness? Oh, she can handle sickness. Let me attack her finances. Oh, she's lonely. Let me bring this man that's not of God in her life. Okay. He comes to kill, steal, and destroy. He studies your habits. He sees what you're watching. He listens to what you hear. He's looking for an avenue to get to you. Back to Luke, watch this. Says the devil five, taking him up the high mountain, showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of a time. And the devil said unto him, all this power I will give thee, and the what? Glory of them. For that is what? Delivered unto me, and to whomsoever I will, I give it. Y'all see this? He said, it was the, he showed them all the kingdoms of the what? Earth. And the glory of those kingdoms. Y'all see this? Then he said, all this power, he said, I can give you all this. And the glory of it. What is the glory of the earth? I'm just, what is it? Things. Position.
Power.
Money. Things. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. The lust of the eyes. Things. The lust of the flesh. Feeling. Your senses. Come on, somebody. He governs those things. Come on, somebody. If he can control you with things, if he can control your senses, if he can control, put you in a position, then he's got you. Will Job serve you for not? Come with me. Come with me to James. I hope y'all come back and see Bishop again. I know this rough tonight, but I gotta get this out, man. This ain't no shouting message, but you know what? We need to hear this. We need to hear this, man, because you don't need to be struggling as a Christian. You need to know who you are in Christ Jesus. And if you don't know who you are, then you're a candidate to be attacked like this. Because you're gonna get attacked anyway. My question is, are you prepared for the attack? Because he's coming. Whether you like it or not, he is coming to steal, kill, and destroy. He's coming seeking whom he may devour. Put on the whole armor of God that you may stand against the wiles of the devil. Wiles, strategy, craftiness, and strategic. He has a strategic plan for you. The military, before you go to war, don't you have a strategy? Don't you come up with a plan? And then don't you scheme on your enemy? A schemer, he's a schemer. That means he watches the enemy. He knows his enemy. Am I right about it?
You're right, amen.
And then he used a strategic, Jesus said, if Satan's kingdom was divided, how can it stand? That means there's order in Satan's kingdom, but it's chaos. Okay. Satan has order. Paul said, watch this. He said, there was a messenger of Satan sent to buffet me in his flesh. Satan strategically sent the messenger to buffet Paul. That means he studies your habits. You are his enemy. They like to gossip. Let me get them to find somebody to gossip with. I want to bring division to the church. Who's the candidate?
Wow, that's good, sir. That's good, sir.
That's right, sir. That's good.
Come on, somebody.
That's good,
don't make, see, the devil hung around with Jesus now. When Jesus walked the earth, the devil was at church.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
I need to go find where Jesus at. I need to condemn him. He's breaking the Sabbath. Jesus told the Pharisee, your father is the devil.
Yep.
The devil at church, man.
Yeah.
Trying to bring chaos in the church. He's seeking whom he may devour. He's studying you. And God said, if they knew what they were dealing with, they would hit their knees. Because knees get the devil off you.
Yeah.
Praying get him off you, man. If you knew how important that word was, Jesus said, it is written every time the devil came.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all still with me?
Amen.
James. Watch this. See, we gotta stop. God said the devil is wreaking havoc in folks' lives and they're blaming God. And God want to deliver you. The Bible says that God is what?
Spirit.
God is a spirit. God is love. God is light. And in him is no darkness. He's the God of comfort. Oh, come on, somebody. God is love. God is light. God is not hate.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
God is not evil.
Amen.
God didn't take your kids. God didn't cause your parents to die. God didn't do it. The devil did.
Yeah.
Amen.
Watch this. See, people look at, oh, why would God allow? You got to go back to Adam. We in a fallen world. With murder. Everything you can name is in this world. That's why God sent Jesus. The scripture says in 1 John that he would destroy the works of the devil.
Yes. Amen.
That's good. Watch. Blame it on Adam. He handed it all over to him.
That's good.
And the devil is using the same tactic that he used with Adam. He attacked the flesh then, and he's attacking the flesh now. When Adam declared and decreed, he said, this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his one flesh, his wife. Watch this. He said, and cleave to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. He shall leave his father. In other words, that word leave, abandon the father. He abandoned the father for his flesh. And the enemy is using the same thing he did to Adam on you. They'll forsake the father for the flesh. If I can get them in their flesh. Watch this. James 1, are you there? You there? James, a servant of God, of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting. My brethren, count it what? When you what? If you fall. So it's just a matter of time. When you fall. Tell your neighbor when you fall. That means you're going to fall into temptation. He didn't say count it all joy if you fall.
No.
Count it all joy when you fall. But when you fall into temptation, are you prepared for temptation?
Right.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
Watch this. Knowing that the trying of your faith worketh what?
Patience.
But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect or made whole, entire, wanting nothing. Jump over to verse 12. Blessed is the man that endureth what?
Temptation.
For when he is tried, he shall receive what?
Crown of life.
Which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. That love him. Let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempteth he any man. Yep, y'all see that? Y'all see this? We're going to come back. Go to Matthew. Matthew chapter 4. Will you let us say amen? Verse 1.
Amen.
Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit. That's count it all joy. When you fall into what? Jesus was God in the flesh. But the Holy Ghost led him to be tempted. Oh, wow. You better be led by the Holy Ghost when temptation comes. Oh, come on, somebody. When you fall into temptation, please be led by the Spirit. Be full of the Holy Ghost when temptation comes. Then you can resist. Come on, somebody. You can either fall into temptation or you can be drawn away by temptation. I'd rather fall into temptation than to be drawn away by my temptation. By my own, every man is tempted when he's drawn away of his own lust. So I'd rather fall in instead of be drawn away. What? I'm gonna show you something. Jesus, in another text, said he was led to be tempted. So this is counted all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. Jesus fell into temptation. He was led to it. To be tempted. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
But he was in the Spirit.
Yes.
I like that saying. He was led by the Spirit.
Yes.
It says, and when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward hungry. And when the who?
The tempter.
Satan is the tempter, not God.
Amen.
When the tempter came, he came. So we understand that Satan is the what? Tempter. He's the tempter, not God. And when you focus a mess, the devil made me do it. The devil didn't even make you do it. The devil enticed you to do it. Okay. Come back to James. Oh man, I'm about to hide behind the table. The devil didn't make you do it. You know the devil made me do it. No, he didn't. He just enticed you to do what was already in you.
Yep.
Watch this. 13. Let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God, for God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempt any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Y'all see that?
Mm-hmm.
It is the devil that does the enticing. The lust is yours. Mm-hmm. In other words, if you lust after a woman, he just gonna tell you, ain't nobody watching. Just like he told David when David saw Bathsheba. And the servant came and told David. He said, that's the wife of Uriah, David. Who told David? What was this? He told David. The Bible says she was good to look upon. Love not the world. What's the lust of the what? Eyes. The scripture says she was good to look upon. And when David saw her, he lusted after her. So here comes the servant of David. David said, who is that? They said, that's Bathsheba, the wife of Uriah. He said, go get her. Wait a minute, who gave you the authority to go get her? Didn't he tell you she was married? But I guarantee you the enemy said, you're the king. Whatever you declare and whatever you decree, it's yours. Bring her here anyway. He's drawn away by his own lust. He's enticed to do it. The lust is conceived when the act happens. It says, every man is drawn away of his own lust, and after lust conceives, he's enticed, after lust conceive, it bring forth what? Sin. It brings forth sin. So what happened? David looked, lusted, David looked, lusted, enticed, lust conceived, he fornicated, he committed adultery with Bathsheba, sin came forth, and after sin, the baby died. Is that how it happened? He looked, lusted, enticed, conceived, sin, death. The child shall surely die. He's drawn away of his own lust to bring forth sin, and after sin and finish, it bring forth death. Do not err, my beloved brethren. Every good gift and every perfect gift come from above and cometh down from the Father of lights, in whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Good things come from God, amen, not evil things. Satan is the tempter. Watch this. He attacked. I don't even want to go there. He said, Lord, have you considered? The Lord asked him, Satan, which comest thou? He said, from to and fro. He said, have you considered my servant Job? That there's none like him in all the earth, perfect and upright? Satan turns around, will Job serve the Lord God for naught? You put a hedge around him. You bless the works of his hands. And you got a hedge around him. You bless all that he had. But now touch all that he had. Here's Satan holding a dialect with God. Touch all he had, and he'll curse you to your face. And the Lord said, go. Man, some of y'all need to go back and read Job. Job was self-righteous. And Job feared losing everything he had. At the end of Job, Job repented at the last chapter. If he didn't do nothing, why he had to repent? He repented of his self-righteousness. The devil seeks to destroy you, but God seeks to develop you. So when you fall into diverse temptations, watch this. You need to be in the spirit and know that development is taking place.
Amen.
Job feared losing. I don't want to have my things with fear. God said, I don't want him to have things with fear. Have you considered Job? But here's what the devil does. The scripture says, the first he wiped out all of Job and left one servant to come and tell what had happened. You lost your wealth, Job, and I'm only the one that left to come tell you. The fire of God came down, and he always blames God. Mm-hmm. And that's why people say, look what God has done. But Job said, naked I came into this world, and naked I'll be. the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. Job accepted it. He didn't charge God. He accepted it. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
Then Satan turns around and says, okay, he still ain't cursed God. Well, let's touch his flesh. So Satan caused him to be sick. Sickness is not of God. You know what? He's the tempter. He entices you. I'm just gonna keep it real. You know, some people say, Lord, deliver me from sugar diabetes. And you eat ice cream every day. Well, guess who tempted you to eat that ice cream? Oh, one more don't hurt. Do it again. It don't hurt. He studies your habits. He'll cause an ice cream truck to come your way. So, free ice cream today. Because his main goal is to keep you sick. Man, I'm trying to help somebody. Something little like that, the enemy's in it. He's trying to keep you sick. And then he'll blame God, you ain't getting healed. And God won't, man, I done heard it too many times in the church.
Yeah.
God ain't healing me. God, what I do? What God, what did I do? Well, maybe if you would obey God.
Yeah.
Are y'all with me? God tell you, you need to lose some weight. God tell you, you need to move over there. I like what this brother said. He says, when God illuminates your mind to something, Satan immediately attacks the illumination. Once God calls you to say, oh, I get it now, Satan's going to attack that to see if you really get it. Are you with me? Watch this. Come with me to... By any means, let's go over to Job, right? Job chapter 2. Verse 3. Excuse me, let's do verse 2. And the Lord said unto Satan, from which cometh thou? Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth, from walking up and down in it. And the Lord said unto Satan, hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, perfect and upright, a perfect and upright man, one that feareth God and is true of evil, and still he hold fast his integrity, although thou movest me against him to destroy him without cause. And Satan answered the Lord and said, skin for skin, yea, all a man have will he give for his life. But put forth thy hand now and touch his bone and his flesh, and he will curse thee to thy face. Satan just trying to get you to give up on God.
Yeah.
And he'll attack you in any kind of way to either give up or give in. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
You'll give up from the trials or you'll give in to the lust. There's only two ways. He'll bring trials in your life. Right here, he was trying to get Job to give up. He got Samson to give in. He got David to give in. We either give in or give up. He's coming one way. He's bringing trials in your life. He's bringing sickness in your life. He's bringing distress in your life. He said, give up or give in or trust God's word. And Job said, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. James said, remember the patience of Job. Job was self-righteous, but Job was patient with God. He said, I will wait till my change come. And a lot of us can't wait till the change come. Job didn't give up. He waited, and he was self-righteous. Fearful of losing everything. His own wife said, Job, curse God and die. And that's the second time the devil tried to blame God for doing something wrong to Job. And it was the devil doing it. What am I saying? Stop blaming. All good things come from God. Amen. God is fighting for you. He's not fighting against you. He's for you. Amen. Satan comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Satan's trying to take you out every day. It's the grace of God and the mercy of God. If Satan could have his way, he'd wipe the whole world out. But it's God's mercy. But he has, watch this. The Lord showed me, he said, the Bible said, walk in the spirit, you won't fulfill the lust of the flesh. When you're in your flesh, Satan has legal right to attack you. Legal right. You leave yourself open for him. And if you're not praying, you leave yourself open for him. When you're in your flesh, the spirit lusteth against the flesh and the flesh against the spirit. There's a war going on inside of you. And when you leave yourself open physically, when you are in your flesh, you are a candidate for the enemy. But Job waited on the Lord. Job was patient and waited on God. The thief comes to, you know, I'm telling you this because he attacks me. He attacks you mentally. Come on, somebody. He attacks you physically. He'll attack you spiritually. He'll attack your wealth. He'll attack your children. You gotta use your weapons on the enemy. If you're not praying, pray. You might not pray like Bishop, but something, get on your knees and thank God for you seeing another. Thank you. Yes, say amen. Something.
Yes, amen.
I just feel this urgency in my spirit. Pray. Prayer kept a gun, a bullet from going through my head. Because when the brother was shooting at me, my mother was praying at that same time. I'm telling you, prayer changes that. God said, the Lord said, prayer keeps the enemy off you. Prayer put angels. Job said, the thing said, you got a hedge around Job. Not a hedge of trees, a hedge of angels. Yes. You got angels around you. I can't get to them. Each one of you got an angel assigned to you.
Amen.
But my question is your angel active in your life? Because prayer activates your angel. Come on, somebody. Is your angel at work in your life? Because I'm telling you, the thief coming to steal, kill, and destroy everything that you have. He's seeking whom he may devour. He's the God of this world system. That's why the scriptures say, be not conformed to this world. Don't follow the world's pattern. He controls it. That's why you see murder over here. You see neighborhoods full of drugs. He controls regions. He's got demonic forces in these regions. The only way they can be delivered is the kingdom of God, the gospel, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's the only way they can be delivered. We got a heroin problem right here in Sierra Vista. The devil is running ramshot here. Well, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray.
Yes, amen.
We, I I'm telling you, I feel this thing on me. That some of you need to go home and pray tonight. If you haven't gotten on your knees, well, Bishop, I don't say, Lord, thank you.
Amen.
For waking me up. You didn't get up on your own. Some of you didn't even thank God for letting you see another day. You didn't get up. It's a whole lot of people didn't wake up this morning.
Amen.
But you did. Did you thank God for that? Did you say, Lord, watch over me when I... You don't know who's coming in your house. You don't know what's going on when you sleep. Lord, watch over me. Because he's looking for opportunity to take you out. And prayer changes things.
Amen.
You don't need another sermon. You don't need another awesome sermon. You don't need to shout. You don't need to lift your head. You don't need to pray. You need to pray. It vexes my spirit to see the people of God get attacked the way they are. And we just go with the flow of things. Don't you know you're the light of the world? People are watching your lives. People are hurting in this world. They're watching us, Christians. People need something to hope in. I heard a brother say, if we're the body of Christ, how come we don't... A Muslim said this. Man, the Christians do not look like they're Christ. And if we are the body, how come we're not reaching? How come we're not healing? How come we're not helping? We're the body. What in the world going on with Bishop? Something's stirred up in my spirit. And it's going to come out the way God wanted to. Because I'm going to yield to him until it does. But it's not about a sermon. It's not about... God said my people need to understand. They're in warfare. Every day you get up, I care about you. Don't make the same mistakes over and over and over. That's a foolish man. Someone that repeats the same thing, do the same thing. That's a foolish man. Didn't learn nothing from his mistake. Pray about everything that you do. Pray about it. Lord, is this the, should I do that? Or you become a prey. Is that all right?
Amen. Amen.
There's a thing, there's an attack. Okay, I'm gonna say there's an attack on this church. There's an attack on the leadership. Why? Because God wants to do something great here.
Yes.
So the enemy said, let me infiltrate and attack. And God said, the private lives are not lining up with the church life. I'm just telling you, like, I'm telling you what God gave you. You don't have to like before. God said your private life is not lining up with the appearance to the church. And if you're a Christian, you need to be a Christian in private and open. Because what you do in secret, it'll come out openly. If we pray secretly, it'll manifest openly. You're an example to this church. You represent this church. Watch what you put on Facebook. You can't just throw anything on Facebook and you're in leadership in this ministry. You can't throw anything on Facebook and you say, I'm a CHF member, but you know, anything goes.
Amen.
So, because people watching. That's what they got going on over there. That's how they do it over there. And what it shows is you're praying because you're not praying.
Yeah.
It's time to stop all this nonsense. The enemies come in, people are otherwise minded. It's time to stop that. If you're a part of this work, get to work. Get to work for the house of God. You can do something. Because the more you're busy for God, you'll stop being idle-minded. And the devil's playground. Come on, somebody. We got people starting to put their hands to the plow. But we need more to get busy. I'm praying for you. And that's why you're getting this kind of message. Because I pray for you. Brittany's taking over our computer, the website. Was over last night. Want to get busy. My heart is heavy for you. You should be further than where you're at. Don't allow your flesh to get you off track.
Yes.
Why am I saying this publicly? Because I'm not playing. I'm not playing. We love God. We're under grace. But there is such thing as sin. And you cannot frustrate the grace of God with your flesh. It's time for us to stand up and be who we say we are. Make a stand. Why don't you stand for God? You're going to get attacked anyway. So why don't you stand for something? Because if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. So stand for God. Make a declaration today, I'm standing for you, Lord. I'm going to change some things on my Facebook. I'm going to stop saying what I want to say on Facebook. You have it. Because if I hear anything, especially leaders, doing some ungodly or appearing some kind of way on Facebook, I'm going to deal with you. Because that's not who we are. As a ministry. That's not who we are as Christians. We don't look and act like the world. We're Christ-like. We're written epistles. People are seeing your life. And I don't never want to hear nobody say, man, they're going to your church. Everybody in church ain't gonna be right, but people that really get at work in the ministry should be having a form of godliness. They're not just a form of godliness, but their heart should be full of godliness. People got a form of godliness, but deny the power. You need to have a form and the power.
Yes.
Be ye holy, for I am holy. Father, this is what God has given me. I'm closing my Bible. That's what he gave me in prayer. He said, be careful that you don't have that Ananias and Sapphira spirit. What do I mean by that? Ananias means Yahweh is gracious. Sapphira means beautiful. Look it up. Don't have an appearance that everything is gracious. And everything is beautiful when your private life don't line up with it. Because privately, their life didn't line up with what it appeared to be. And guess what happened? They got exposed. Did they not? Don't have an appearance that you're holy. Be holy. Don't have an appearance that everything is beautiful. Let things be beautiful on the inside. I know I ain't miss God tonight. But he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. People that get up and walk out on this mess, and the people that get up, the very ones that need it. You want a severe attack. Some of you are attacked now. You know what you're doing with God. What are you doing when it's just you and God? God wants you to be perfect, entire, wanting nothing, lacking nothing. He wants to make you complete. Will you let him do that for your life? Come on, give him a hand.